You have to see. I know you're busy. What do you need, sir? Sir,
I want to give you a word of warning.
Sir, I don't know what you heard, but whatever it is, Jefferson started it.
Thomas Jefferson resigned this morning. You're kidding. I need a favor.
Whatever you say, sir, Jefferson will pay for his behavior.
Shh.
I'll use the press I'll write under a pseudonym. You'll see what I can do to him.
I need you to draft an address.
Yes, he resigned. You can finally speak your mind.
No. He's stepping down so he can run for president.
Well, good luck defeating you, sir.
I'm stepping down. I'm not running for president.
I'm sorry, what?
One last time. Relax, have a drink with me. One last time. Let's take a break tonight and then we'll teach them how to say goodbye. To say goodbye. You and I.
No, sir.
I want to talk about neutrality.
Sir, with Britain and France on the verge of war, is this the best
time? I want to warn against partisan fighting. But pick up a pen, start writing. I want to talk about what I have learned. The hard-won wisdom I have earned.
As far as the people are concerned, you have to serve.
You could continue to serve.
No. Say you're weak.
No, they will see we're strong.
But your position is so unique.
So I'll use it to move them along.
Why do you have to say goodbye?
If I say goodbye, the nation learns to move on. It outlives me when I'm gone. Like the scripture says, everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. They'll be safe in the nation we've made. I wanna sit under my own vine and fig tree. I'm moving alone in the shade. At home in this nation we've made. One last time.
One last time.
Though, in reviewing the incidents of my administration, I am unconscious of intentional error. I am nevertheless too sensible of my defects not to think it probable that I may have committed many errors. I shall also carry with me the hope that my country will view them with indulgence, and that after 45 years of my life dedicated to its service with an upright zeal, the faults of incompetent abilities will be consigned to oblivion, as I myself must soon be, to the mansions of rest. I anticipate with pleasing expectation that retreat in which I promise myself to realize the sweet enjoyment of partaking in the midst of my fellow citizens. The benign influence of good laws under a free government, the ever favorite object of my heart, and the happy reward is the trust of our mutual cares, labors, and dangers. One last time.
Don't you teach them